is you receive the script, and it was kind of ridiculous from the outset because it was about a tiger loose in Africa. There are no tigers in Africa. So what had happened is in transport, this tiger had gotten loose and was terrorizing the villagers. So they engaged Tarzan in this enterprise of finding this tiger and solving the solution. And so Tarzan undertakes it. And he hunts the tiger for the duration of the show. So I'm reading and reading and reading, and then I get to the part that says, Tarzan and tiger meet. Tarzan and tiger fight. Tarzan and tiger become exhausted. Tarzan and tiger look at each other with great respect, and tiger turns and walks away into the jungle, and Tarzan lets him go. Well, you can imagine what must have gone through my veins. I mean, it was not ice water. I was immediately understanding that this could be the one. This could be it. In the first place, we didn't have a tiger. So what were we going to do? And the second place, none of us knew anything about tigers. I mean, we knew something about, I had learned a lot about lions and leopards. And I knew them. I knew elephants pretty well. We'd had an elephant go berserk and kill 3 people on our show. So I knew the danger signs were these. I had no clue what a tiger was. Great news. They got a tiger. From Tigerland, from not a zoo, and from where tigers live, they had captured a tiger. And it was being brought to the San Diego Zoo. But because we needed a tiger, they were going to instead bring him to us. This transpired 2 weeks, I think. I may have this wrong. Maybe 4 weeks, but it was a matter of weeks, countable weeks. Before this was set to be filmed. And it was to be filmed on a Saturday in Mexico. And at any rate, what happened? The tiger came. We had the tiger brought to us, wonderful cages and all that sort of thing. And I started feeding the tiger. I wanted to be present every time the tiger was fed. And so I went through that process with the tiger, to the point where we got to the Saturday for the fight. And we had huge, tall fences built and standards with cameras on it, had five cameras to film, had probably 6 or 7 people with still cameras, had as much protection as we could get. I didn't allow guns, but I did allow poles and all kinds of things around the perimeter. And so we put the tiger out, put him on a quick release on the ground, a chain that would release in a hurry, and put him down, had him well fed. I put it off just as long as I really could before it became noticeable that I was scared to death. And finally, it was time, so I went out and I gave the signal to roll the cameras, get them going, and they counted off speed, every one of them, and as soon as I had them all up to speed, I said, okay, tiger, let's go. I took off the little snap chain, and so the tiger just, it was down. And this is a 650-pound animal, and it was down, just kind of looking at me. And so I slapped him on the nose. And is that the best you got, he seemed to be saying? I mean, it was like that. I hit him again, but I knew there was one thing that would make that tiger attack me. If I turned my back on him and ran, he would have it. Last thing I wanted to do, but it was what I had to do, and I did it, and I turned my back, but I didn't get more than about a step when I heard that little And I turned around, the tiger was in the air above my head. Now, he had been down, flat. You've seen dogs lie down, it's the same way. And he went from that to this. Then the fight took place. Now, it was play. When I hit him on the nose and done all those things, he recognized that as play. And he came down on me when I took him, when I received him and went to the ground with him, and then we began to tussle and roll. He was playing. He was playing. He was still hitting me. But the thing I found out about a tiger is lions do this. All other cats do this. Tigers do this and this. They karate chop. What a time to learn that. So we did that for 3 days. Actually, I think it was probably about 3 minutes. But it was one of the longest 3 minutes I ever had. And I was exhausted. I was depleted of every ounce of energy I had at the end of that time. Plus, I was bleeding out of my ears. And the tiger stopped, and I was, my arms were at my side. I couldn't move. And the tiger looked at me, and I looked at him, and he just sort of turned around and went back. And we had had him staked before. Exactly. What the script did. That's the tiger story.